We're here for the talk about the design. We all are familiar with the design right now, I think, after 5 days. But there's a lot behind it. And in this talk, Crystal Saunders will tell us everything behind the design. Give it up for Crystal.
Well, hi all, welcome. Welcome at the last day of this wonderful festival. Everything looks very nice in this festival, and that's because we had a really great design. We had something very large to build up to, like the awesome 2017 design, who was really generative, and we built on this. And we got this nice dual tone design, and I'm going to talk a bit more about the ideas behind it. So first, a small thing about me. I'm Bookworm, also known as Crystal Saunders. I have two main things people need to know about me. I love purple, and I love stories. And there are some stories about the design that I want to tell with you right now. So, I didn't make the design. I've been part of the team. I've been trying to coordinate things. But there are two people who are really need to be a shout out for this. This is Bleeptrek and Nicolette. Bleeptrek and Nicolette. Yes. Somewhere in the 2019, we started to talk about having a design. I got these two wonderful women together and did a brainstorming session. And that was the first part we did for this design. Afterwards, we worked on it. There are a lot of people we have to thank for. Stitch is the one who made the generator mostly. I did some parts, and there are a lot of people who did small things. I can't shout out to all of them, but I want to thank them. So, when we look at the 2017 design, it was these six bars who had these nice mustardy colors, and everybody could make their own design, their own flag for their village, for their solution, for their own projects. They could make everything. And this, for a lot of people, was fun, and we wanted to make this to the next level. But we also wanted to make it colorful, and we want to make it generative and work with black and dark white backgrounds. These are make it a bit harder, so we left away with the entire completely random design, and we went to a fixed colors. But one of the other wishes we had was to make it more fit in with the rest of the team, with the rest of the field, with the rest of the event. And so we looked at the call for participation, and there was there a motto that spoke to us. The motto was, the future will eventually be consistent, but what kind of consistency it will have. And we think, we can do something with this. Eventually consistent, that means that in the end it will be one coherent thing, and we want to have something like that in the design. So we brainstormed a bit more, and we thought about consistent, fitting things, reflections. Yeah, we can do something with that. Some other ideas we had was we wanted to have a colorful, bright color palette because we thought, you know, it might be coming a bit depressive year with all the things that happened in 2020, 2021. So we wanted to have a colorful design. And what we had, we checked a lot and we come out to this dual tone design you see right here. It's a color palette with purples, with greens, with yellow, and with a pink. And as you can see, it works great on a field. It looks very colorful. I'm happy with it. We also wanted to do something with reflections, with a bit of physics, with all those kind of things. And what we had is one of the things we found, this beautiful butterfly, who have clear wings. And if you shine some light through them, it will shimmer a bit, it will refract a bit. And we went on that, and what we ended up with was a kaleidoscope. So what we did, we made a kaleidoscope, and a kaleidoscope means that you have one base image and a lot of reflections on it, and every reflection might be a bit different, but the end is consistent. And that's why we have the design, a kaleidoscope design. Well, some practical things about kaleidoscopes. They're full of triangles, That also means that it's full of hexagons, and hexagons are, as we all know, the bestagons. So we have a design full of hexagons. That's nice. We can do a lot of that. And we also see those nice PCB traces. And those PCB traces are randomly generated based on the input string. So it's consistent with the string, but every string will get a SHA hash, because, you know, we're part of the SHA 2017 design. We're evolving from that. So we're using the same SHA hash, and we use that as the seed for the random generator that makes these traces. This is BleepTrack's work, and it's awesome. It's made in PaperJS, and then it's put into a view interface that is really complicated, and I'm really happy with the people who helped us out with that, because it's working great for most part. But I've seen most of people using it, so it should have a great usability. What we also use is those SHA hash. We also use to generate the main color for the text. We used it for the main color of the triangles. And all of this is done in PaperJS in your browser. And that means that for every string, there is every time the same output. So that's cool. We also put some other options from it. So if you go to design.mch2020.org, you're going to get this design generator. And you can change some parameters. You can make a monochrome version. You can use standard colors. And if you want to go really, really funky, we also have some options like blend modes and opacity changes. But also, you want stars? Add them. You want emoji? Fine, we have a field for that. So we wanted to have something very, very versatile. And I think, yes, we succeeded in that. Thank you. But this event is called May Contain Hackers. So what this design was missing was the hacker. Some strings, and not all of them, around 42% of them, has a hacker in them. We use this very nice icon. It's a restyled icon from the Gnome project. They have icons that are usable. They have a lot of set. It's really great. And there is a random chance, based on the input string, that you have this hacker in your design. And that's cool. But it also brings up the question, what is a hacker? And the thing is, there is no protected title for this. Everybody can call them a hacker. And the thing is, there are around more 3,200 hackers on this field, and I'm pretty sure there are more than 3,200 definitions of hackers on this field right now. But the thing is, they all mirror a set of ideals and an ethical base. So we're all reflections of the same core ethics, and that's what one of the things that unites us. And this ethical base, let's call them a hacker ethic, is something that's something that's defined a long time ago. Somewhere in the 80s, Stephen Levy wrote a book, and his book, he defined the hacker ethics. And this is a product from its era. So what he said is that computers should have access, so everybody should have access to computers, and information should be free, distrust authority, but promote decentralization, and we should judge each other based on your merits and not on your background. But like the hacker ethics, this is something from that era. We built on it. Sometimes we change it. We all reflect on it. It's a kaleidoscope. You reflect everything. And what we use right now is something that reflects from this. For the design, however, there is like one main thing in this hacker ethics that we really take to our heart, and that is, you can create art and beauty with computers. We did this in a very beautiful design, but keep in mind, you can do this in a different way. Every piece of code can be beautiful. Every piece of hardware can give beautiful results. We all can do this, and this is something nice. This is something you can really learn on Hacker Event. We all make beautiful things, and if we share them, we can all enjoy them. So, back to design. What do we have? We have a triangular grid, which is an infinity reflecting grid. We have some area where some text can be, and we have a generator available. The generator may or may not contain a hacker, And we have 5 base colors with PCB traces and a nice font. And it's made in PaperJS and Bootstrap Vue. But this was somewhere end of 2020, and then this happened. COVID. MCH28, where this design for was made, was canceled. This was really shitty. Was not a fun time, but you know, what do you do when you have a shitty time? You make some t-shirts. So we made a design for the meh, it didn't happen t-shirt. And some people may laugh right now because there is some history here. The Dutch hacker camps each time have a different name. And before we went for May Contain Hackers, what we maybe should have think a bit more because the May was very uncertain. But you know, we are all here, so that's great. But before we had that name, this was the proposal. So we have meh, met elkaar hacken, and we could put that on the t-shirt. So this name did come back. But we're a year further, and right now we are at MCH 2022. For a few more hours, we are on this great festival, and we have a lot of things on the field that look really, really great. For example, we have the gate, and the main gate looks beautiful. It's great, it is triangles, it has some reflective CDs, so it is everything that I could have wanted with the design. Thank you very much, Deco Team, it looks awesome. And so, we did this on a lot of things, and to come back to this design where we have, where we all are reflections of the SAM ethics with our own flavor, Resume, and who was part of the Deco Team, did a really, really great job. We've seen all the flags around the site. They are not one hexagon from the generator, but they are all different hexagons. And every hexagon has its own meaning. If you look right here, we have some based on sharing. We have some based for angels. Thank you, angels. We have some for nerds. We have a party. We have hacker in there. We have makers. We have programming. Like most of the things, the definers are representative in this flag. So I'm really happy we could have this. And this is part what makes this event beautiful. We also put the design on the booklet. And I have to make a small either piece of humble pie. We take the booklet. We take a picture from Sebastian Humbeck, which was great. It's a really lovely picture. We used it everywhere. We used attribution everywhere. But it went away in the booklet. Therefore, there's this shout out. Thank you a lot. Thank you for not making a problem of this. Okay, and if you looked around the site for the last few days, you've seen a lot of t-shirts appearing. We have this t-shirt, where the generator is mostly Bleetrex design, the t-shirt, the hoodies, and the headwear are mostly Nicolette's design. What you see here is the butterfly we have in the beginning with the reflective wings. We have a light beam coming up through the to the butterfly and spreading apart in all the colors that we have as MCH. And there are a few more things I want to highlight in this design. As you can see, there are some, how shall we call them? Some formulas and some technical drawings in there. What you see is a drawing and the formulas for how light is reflected in a prism. And what you also see is how a kaleidoscope is working. These things we wanted to put on the hoodie so everybody can see, yes, there is a physical basis and everything behaves like rules, but we make our own flair of it. The other thing is that we have this nice hexagon design and we wanted to utilize it somewhere on the shirt. And what we have right now is that one sleeve of the hoodie and one of the t-shirt is completely in this fabric based on this design. And because it's purple, it's blends in a tiny bit, but it's very visible. It was very fun to walk around last night and see everybody with these hoodies, and it looked beautiful. Thank you all for wearing them. The model of this t-shirt is a Raglan t-shirt. So if somebody else wants to make something like this, a Raglan has the sleeve in a separate way, and that way you can make these nice, seamless designs. Yeah. But apart from the hoodie, apart from the t-shirt, and apart from the flags, and all the other nice things that were on the site, I've seen other people making use of the design. We put this on a lot of places. We have like mirrors and kaleidoscope kind of things on the field. We had the prisms with the dichroic foil, which reflects the light in a different way. It was awesome. We had a lot of wristbands in a lot of colors. And we seen that some colors were more popular than others. But, well, they were there and they helped to make the design more comfortable. And then we had like the, how do you call them? The name tags that were everywhere. We had a printer at Heaven who could make them, which means that we have them. We also had, for a lot of things, for example, for cars, we had like A5 papers with all area access for the vehicles that had that for a limited time. They were stolen, so right now we don't have any anymore. So, you know, if you have one, return, would be nice. But that means we didn't have them, but people saw them. More people wanted to have them. So what our friends at the POC did, they also had a color printer, and they printed out some more credit card-sized cards with all area access on it. And you see that wearing people around. So if you want to have an all area access, these are the people you have to talk about. Lastly, I want to thank you all for being here. It was a really fun event. It was really colorful. And I want to thank you all for bringing your own flavor of hacker to make this kaleidoscope of an event really beautiful. Thank you all for being there, bringing your own story. I enjoyed it a lot. And the last thing I want to bring back is the theme from the call for participation. The future will eventually be consistent, and it's up to us, us all, to make sure what kind of consistency we have. Please bring your own. I hope really you are inspired with this camp and you bring back your own inspiration from this camp to make the world a better, a more beautiful, or a more safer place. Thank you all and have a good year.
Yes. Thank you very much for this this insight in the design. It's really cool. Does anyone have any questions about this? If you have, you can walk up to the microphone in the middle and you can ask the question.
Hi. I missed out on the hats. And I saw on the wiki that there was at least an exchange. But do you think there is a chance that more will be made?
Right now, there are no plans to make an extra merch run. Mm-hmm. We also saw it was very popular. So we will take it in consideration. But making merch this year was interesting. This design is very complex, and we have to see. It's not viable to do this for a small run, so we really have to see. But we will keep you updated if we do.
Thank you.
Right. Was that the only question? Then I'd like everyone to make some noise for Crystal.